Inauguration celebration took place on a special day. It's Martin Luther King Jr. Day. People are honoring Dr. King across the country, including here in Central Florida. WESH 2's Michelle Meredith is live in Winter Park. And Michelle, you've talked to several people about the importance of this big day.
I did. We're here in Hannibal Square in Winter Park, where the party, the celebration, and the amazement over this special day continues.
God, so help me God.
Congratulations, Mr. President.
In West Winter Park, folks interrupted one celebration, Martin Luther King's birthday, to witness on live TV another, the inauguration of Barack Obama as president. Eyes were transfixed, hearts full of emotion.
Glad to just to be here, to be alive, to be an American.
Unbelievable. Just unbelievable. It's just history in the making. I mean, how can you not be excited about it?
It was history in the making. The nation's first African-American president being sworn in for his second term using Bibles from Abraham Lincoln and Martin Luther King Jr. And it's all happening on the day we celebrate King's birthday.
Because I have a dream.
In Eatonville, the oldest incorporated African-American city in the nation, they called it a doubleheader.
If we can have a doubleheader, as far as African-Americans are concerned, this would be our doubleheader, and we're able to pay homage to the legacy and to show that we're actually fulfilling it. We are actually fulfilling it.
There you go. A day of great pride and a day where parades are a reminder of a man, a dream, and a nation chasing the dream one step, one day at a time.
This day just shows that, you know, our country was based on freedom, and if we all just come together in unity, we all have one common goal, we can reach that common goal together.
Now, we heard a lot of optimism today, but we also heard from a lot of folks that say they wish the two parties, Republicans and Democrats, could get along better in the next 4 years. Live in Orange County, Michelle Meredith, WESH 2 News.